Introduction to the Delta-Y Transformer Connection, Part 6D. This is where we left off in Part 6C, okay? Now, in this part, we're going to explain what this means and how this works, right? Now, we said in the last video that this is often referred to as the open form phasor diagram, and this is often referred to as the closed form phasor diagram. Now, the open form versus closed form phasor diagrams have their own advantages, and that's what we're going to talk about in this video. When I was first learning this phasor diagram, the closed form phasor diagram, was very confusing. I never understood it. To be honest, it was only recently that I actually understood what was going on here. The open form was always a lot easier to visually and conceptually understand, but this closed form, it's a work of art. Okay, so the way that it works is that, first of all, it's really helpful to label our phasor windings to get our visual understanding. Now, this phasor here, that's VAG, and it's pointing to this corner of this triangle. So I'm going to call this A, okay? This is VBG, and it's pointing to this corner here. So I'm going to call this B, and this is VCG. It's pointing at this corner here, so I'm going to call this C, okay? The number one problem for the closed form phasor diagram is that this triangle, the shape, it makes us mentally think that the triangle represents line to ground A, B, and C voltages of the power system. Okay? And we clearly see that it doesn't, right? The triangle actually represents the line-to-line voltage of the delta transformer connection, but that is also equal to the winding voltage, right? But our line-to-ground voltages are actually these inner phasors. That's one of the problems for this closed form, that it makes us think differently, okay, when we first visually inspect it. So the second problem for this closed form phasor diagram is that when we look at this, we think that the origin represents the neutral or the ground. And by inspection, the neutral is equal to the ground. And then the question comes up, well, why is VAN equal to VAG? And then the last thing is number three, the most confusing thing about this closed form phasor diagram is that why is VAB, right, VBC, and then VCA shown in this particular manner, right? It appears that the voltage drop is, for VAB, for example, this voltage drop should be from B to A, right? Because the arrow is pointing in this direction. So this voltage drop is from B to A, but what we've written down is VAB. Same thing over here. So when we initially inspected, it appears that this voltage drop, this phasor, should be VAC because we start from A and then we go to C. But in reality, phasor is VCA. And then same thing over here. By inspection, it appears to be VCB, but in reality, it's VBC. So the voltage drop isn't as what we've defined it. That's the third reason why the closed form is so confusing. Although it has its confusion, the content is very true and very correct. We just have to understand what this is telling us. And if we compare that to the open form, everything becomes very, very clear. We know what VAG is, we know what VAB is, and we know what's lagging and what's leading and how much it's lagging and leading and blah, 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 blah. So what's the benefit, I guess? What's the benefit of this form, right? What's the benefit of this closed form phasor diagram? Well, the biggest benefit that this form provides us is that it tells us how the transformer windings for the delta is connected. Let me repeat. This phasor diagram tells us how the transformer windings for the delta connection, how those windings are actually connected. And this is the trick that I'm going to explain. This is what's really neat about this closed form phasor diagram. So let me clean this up. You see this here, this phasor here, we've defined this as this phase A winding, right? Now I'm going to zoom in. So So we've defined this phasor here as V phase A, right? V phase A. And we said that this side here, the dotted side, is the polarity side of V phase A. Now, look at what the polarity side of V phase A is connected to. It's connected to the non-polarity side of V phase C, right? So this is V phase C. The polarity side of V phase A is connected to the non-polarity side of V phase C. And then look at what the polarity side of V phase C is connected to. That's connected to the non-polarity side of V phase B. And the polarity side of V phase B is connected to the non-polarity side of V phase A. You guys all see that? So let's back up. And then let's compare it to our actual transformer connection. Okay, so what are we actually saying here? We're saying that this phasor here, right? The polarity side of V phase A is connected to the non-polarity side of V phase C. Okay, so this is our phasor here that represents this phasor diagram here. So the polarity side of V phase A, which is this diagram here, polarity side of V phase A, which is this here, that's connected to the non-polarity side of V phase C. Okay, so polarity side of V phase A is connected to non-polarity side of V phase C. The polarity side of V phase C, which is this winding here, that's connected to the non-polarity side of V phase B. So the polarity side of V phase C, which is right here, that's connected to the non-polarity side of V phase B. Okay, and then lastly, the polarity side of V phase B is connected to the non-polarity side of V phase A. So the polarity side of V phase B is connected to the non-polarity side of V phase A. And there you have it. So this closed form phasor diagram, it represents how this transformer is actually physically connected. And that's the most important thing that it tells us.